The axillary nerve, it is arising from the posterior part of the brachial plexus. The posterior cord is situated behind the third part of the axillary artery. So, axillary artery backside posteriorly, and there is a posterior cord is there. This posterior cord gives the axillary nerve and the upper axillary nerve 1, upper subscapular nerve 2, and there is a lower subscapular nerve and nerve to the latissimus dorsi, and this means these three, they arises from the posterior cord branches. Posterior cord branches are three. The one is this one, and it is called by the upper subscapular nerve. And the second branch, it is a nerve to latissimus dorsi. And third branch, it is called by the lower subscapular nerve. Lower subscapular nerve. These four branches, they are arising from the posterior cord of the brachial plexus. This is the posterior cord. Posterior cord, it gives the four branches. One is a axillary nerve, and second one is the upper subscapular nerve, and the third one, that is a nerve to the latissimus dorsi, and the fourth one, that is a lower subscapular nerve. These four nerves, they are the branches of the posterior cord of the brachial plexus. These four nerves, root value is C5, C6, C7, C8 and T1. Because this posterior cord is formed by the posterior divisions of all the trunks. So all the posterior division trunks meet together, they form a posterior cord. Posterior cord, it gives the axillary nerve, upper subscapular, and nerve to the latissimus dorsi, and the lower subscapular nerve. So first this axillary nerve. The axillary nerve number 1, that is a axillary nerve. So this axillary nerve, it supplies to the shoulder joint. And if the axillary nerve is injured, and what happens? There is no movements of the shoulder joint. The shoulder joint movements are flexion, extension, adduction, and abduction. Adduction, abduction, flexion, extension, and rotation. These movements are disturbed. I mean, these movements are disturbed mean there is a less action or otherwise no action, and these things are due to the injury to the axillary nerve. Once again, axillary nerve is a branch of the posterior cord of the brachial plexus, and it supplies the shoulder joint and teres minor muscle is there, and teres minor muscle also it supplies the, and it is very close to the surgical and surgical neck, and it is accompanied by the anterior circumflex humeral vessels and the posterior circumflex humeral vessels. So these things accompanied by the axillary nerve. Suppose here this is a humerus. This one is a humerus. and here there is a posterior cord and it gives up, and here there is a deltoid muscle. This one is a deltoid muscle, and it gives the axillary nerve. It divides the two branches. One is this one, and then it is while going, it gives the branches to the deltoid muscle. This one is the deltoid muscle. This is the posterior surface, huh? The posterior humerus. This one is a humerus. So here what happens? This is the humerus. Humerus in cross section, and it looks like a triangle. You say this is a posterior surface of the humerus. This one is a anteromedial surface. This one is a anteromedial surface. So after origin of this axillary nerve, and it divides into two. One, it is going to like this, and it also supplies to this deltoid muscle, and this superficial branch it supplies to the teres minor muscle. So it supplies to the shoulder joint, and as well as and the deltoid muscle, and also it supplies the teres minor. In these three things, and then here what happens? The deltoid muscle, it helps in the flexion, anterior in clavicular fibers, and it helps in the abduction 90 and 50 to 90 degrees abduction of the arm maintained by the acromion fibers of the deltoid, and extension of the shoulder joint and maintained by with the help of the latissimus dorsi and posterior fibers of the deltoid, and these things, and also and it supplies to the teres minor muscle, and there is a less nerve supply or otherwise no nerve supply leads to the no function of the deltoid and no functions of the shoulder joint, and there is a less or no functions of the teres minor muscle, and that is regarding about this axillary nerve. Next is a nerve to the latissimus dorsi. The nerve to the latissimus dorsi, and it is a branch of the posterior cord of the brachial plexus. After origin, it enters into the substance of the latissimus dorsi muscle, and it supplies to the latissimus dorsi. In latissimus dorsi, it arises from the backside. It is inserted into the floor of the intertubercular surface. So, and there is a constriction of the muscle fibers of the latissimus dorsi. Now, it leads to what happens? I mentioned it is a, there is a medial rotation and the extension of the shoulder joint. These functions are disturbed if there is an injury or otherwise there is a disturbance in the nerve to the latissimus dorsi. And next is a lower subscapular nerve to the latissimus dorsi. Main posterior cord, it gives the axillary nerve. Second is a nerve to the latissimus dorsi. Latissimus dorsi, and another muscle, and that is latissimus dorsi. So this latissimus dorsi, and also and the third muscle is the subscapularis muscle. These three muscles supplied by the muscle nerves, they are arising from the posterior cord of the brachial plexus. So first, upper subscapular nerve, and nerve to the latissimus dorsi, supplies to the latissimus dorsi, and extension of the shoulder joint is difficult, and rotation of the shoulder joint is difficult, and lower subscapular nerve, and it supplies to the subscapularis muscle. subscapularis muscle, it is situated in front of the anterior surface of the subscapular fossa of the scapula, and it is inserted into the lesser tubercle. So it is supplied by the this nerve, lower subscapular nerve and upper subscapular nerve, and this is regarding about the branches of the posterior part of the brachial plexus. So now, and we have to discuss about the median nerve. Median nerve is formed by the lateral root of the median nerve and median root of the median nerve. In lateral root, it is a branch that it is arising from the lateral part of the brachial plexus, and the median root, it is arising from the median part of the brachial plexus, and the anterior to the third part of the axillary artery, and it forms a groove, and the groove is present it is coming from the median root, and lateral root is coming from the lateral side, and they meet together forming on the anterior surface of the third part of the axillary artery, and then the median formation takes place. Meaning here axillary artery is located, and here this one is a posterior part. The axillary artery is here. This one is an axillary artery. It is an axillary artery. So here, this axillary artery, this one is an axillary artery. Axillary artery. Axillary artery. So posterior to the axillary artery, there is a posterior part is there, and lateral to the axillary artery, there is a lateral part is there, and medial to the axillary artery, there is a medial part is there. Suppose if you are keeping